Starts with one, really. One hoping to be two. Isn't that how everything starts? One cell divides into two, into four, into 20,000, and so on until a human being is formed. But it all starts with one. I guess it ends like that, too. Come in alone, leave alone, in between shifting numbers. I noticed her the first day of my sophomore year of high school. I knew instantly that she was the one to make me two.
I didn't like him at first.
I was a show-off.
You were.
Class clown.
Loud.
Everyone in my family is loud. It's the only way to be heard.
I didn't know that until later.
Good thing. I pursued her. She finally responded.
And just like that.
Two.
He kind of grows on you.
I do.
I went off. To college.
One. I dropped out of school. Lost. Moved to Colorado to stay with my uncle's family.
I had fun.
I grew up a little.
Just a little.
I was directionless. My uncle gave me a talk one night and said, if you really want her, go for her.
He called me. It was pretty romantic.
I flew back the next day. Two.
Three.
Three!
I have a son.
Being the only one is the best. Three, but one.
He was a difficult baby, sick most of the time.
I found it hard to be human again.
He had this one patch of hair on the side of his head that was lighter than the rest. A lightning bolt. I always felt that mark meant something.
Stop playing with my hair.
I can't help it. I cannot believe I made you.
Ew!
Mom.
Three.
We tried to become four.
I had taken migraine medication. I didn't know I was pregnant.
Three. The original family.
Don't you want a baby brother or sister?
Three is a good number. We don't need any more.
We kept trying, and finally... Four!
Four!
Four.
She was such an easy baby.
Everything is great. This is great.
I hate you.
Okay. That part wasn't so great.
You are not a part of the original family.
Four.
Four. Four.
But that still didn't satisfy them. The baby makers.
Five, 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 five!
Five!
I got to name him. He looked like me.
Jerk!
I hope you die.
I hope you die! I didn't know. I didn't mean it.
I did.
The fighting got so bad between them, I had to split them apart. I hit my oldest son. I had to hit my son.
I am nervous all the time. One, I don't care about anybody. One.
I dropped out of school. One.
I babied him. He got all of my attention.
One.
The original family.
We have a terrible relationship. Two.
Mama. Two. Two.
Everything was messed up. I just wanted everyone to be happy.
We finally found a program out west. On a farm.
I get to work with horses. It's neat. One.
Four.
I get better. I decide to go to college and become a park ranger.
We all get together at Christmas.
Five!
For the first time, we actually get along. Nobody fights. It's awesome!
I take him to college. It's good between us.
Two.
My son.
Four.
I'd been there a week. I was itching to hike the National Forest a couple of hours away.
I begged him to stay at the dorm, do laundry, catch up on classwork.
I'm not asking your permission, I said. I took a bus and hiked for a couple of miles and set up camp. One. I am a mountain rhythm warrior. One. I decide just one more hike and then I'll leave. The view. Oh. Even when I see it, it's like I can't breathe it in enough to make it real.
When we didn't hear from him on Monday, we started panicking. We called the park rangers. We flew out there.
Two.
Snowstorm. My foot lost traction on the slope, and I slipped, tumbling over and over, face down on the cold snow. Can't walk. I lay there for hours, days, in and out. In and out.
They find his tent by a lake. He had been out on the mountain all night without shelter.
No sign of him.
We lost all hope.
They flew home after a week. Home to break it to us.
Home to wait for the snow to melt.
For the searches to continue.
So he could be found.
I waited and waited for them to find my... find the... Things were just starting to go good for me!
I had the tiniest hope that maybe he was somewhere, kidnapped, living in a cave, something.
Knowing is its own kind of horrible. Empty, desolate, but not knowing.
90 days of not knowing. I kept a calendar. A secret calendar. Every day took us farther and farther away.
It's like we were all lost.
People looked and looked and looked. It made me feel like my life was worth something.
A hiker came across his body 3 months later.
I marked it on my calendar.
That phone call? No.
I felt better once they found me.
Four.
It sucks at school. Now I'm the girl whose brother died.
I'm sorry.
We were just starting to get along.
I know.
I don't want to be the oldest!
People think that once you die, you're magically healed and everything is bright and beautiful. Well, at first it wasn't bright and beautiful, but I do see a sort of horizon. And I know that there's a place of peace for me there somewhere. I just hope that there'll be a place of peace for my family. We're all gonna have to work on that.
I awoke one night to the most amazing feeling. A giant whirlwind circling me. Cradling me. It felt like a hug.
It was.
My therapist says I was hallucinating.
Get a new therapist.
I miss you.
You look like me.
Four?
No, five. Always five. The original family. I could live another 30, 40 years. What if I forget him?
You won't.
I always wanted to be a park ranger, protecting our national treasures. But when I look back now, it's the people who are really the treasures. When you are faced with the possibility of it being an infinitely long time before you meet again, there's just nothing like home. There's nothing like home. There's nothing like family. There's nothing like friends. But still, in the end, there's just
one. One. One.
One.
Don't forget about me. Please. Don't forget about me.